you're here. Hi guys, it's Rachel. It's the third week of September. It's approximately 11:37 a.m., close to lunchtime, and I'm currently here at Douglas College located in Coquitlam. I actually visited the school several months ago, but during that time it was like raining hard. It was gray and dark, so it's actually pretty nice to see the school on a bright sunny day. But fall. It's around this time of the year where Vancouver does get into this gloomy gray setting. But I kind of thrive in it. I mean, I love the rain, coffee shops, the color of the leaves changing, wearing fleece jackets, and being cooped indoors, especially seeing these spooky themed decorations at Walmart. Anyway, before I go off tangent here, let's just cut to the topic of this video, which is on the top 10 affordable colleges in Canada, Alberta Edition. So let's get her done and let's jump right into it. Now, as previously mentioned, I have established some parameters or factors that I've considered in creating this list. I'll keep it short and sweet, but basically, number one, all the schools are DLIs and the programs listed are PGWP eligible. That means if you're hoping to come to Canada on a study permit for more than 6 months, and you're also planning to work in Canada after graduation, then you may consider the schools and programs listed in this video. Second, all the programs listed are 2 years in length. If you want to save money and time, then you get the most benefit by taking a two-year program. Third, I'll go by the list in descending order by tuition cost per year. And I've also included the living cost just right under the tuition cost. That way you have an idea of how much you need to prepare during your stay. However, please be aware that cost is subject to change without notice, and the cost you see does not include miscellaneous fees. So, without further ado, here are the top 10 affordable colleges in Alberta. In 10th place, we have Olds College, located in Olds, Alberta. Hey, Rachel, you wanna hear a joke? Oh no, here we go. Why did the old man fell into the well? Why? He couldn't see that well. We've talked about this. The school offers a variety of programs in business management and sports management, horticulture technologist, agricultural management, and turf grass management. Never heard of that. And the tuition cost per year is at $18,500 Canadian dollars. In 9th place, we have Lakeland College at their campus in Vermilion, Alberta. This school offers a diploma program in animal science technology in beef and dairy with tuition costs at $16,500 Canadian dollars per year. They're also offering an agribusiness program in livestock and crops. So I'm guessing this campus is really into food and agriculture. But they also have another campus in Lloydminster, Alberta, where they offer more business-related programs for the same price tag. All right, so in 8th place, anybody here wanting to take a diploma program in practical nursing?
Aren't you Rachel?
Yes. Are you
YouTuber? Sorry, I saw.
I saw the videos, and you're getting popular. Oh my gosh!
Is this happening for real?
So happy to meet you.
Oh my god! I'm so thankful that you come across my videos, and happy to see you in the flesh. Do you mind if I interview you for a couple questions about like student life?
Yes.
Just really be helpful, especially for my other videos. If you have time,
yes,
but if you're in class, I don't want to rush you. All right, so I just bumped into one of the students here at Douglas College. Can you kindly introduce yourself?
Oh, I'm Paenn Sanchez. I'm taking therapeutic recreation program.
Degree. And right now on my third year.
Wow, that's amazing. And I want to know, like, what are the things that you appreciate about Douglas College?
Well, first of all, I like how it's affordable than other schools, and it's like smaller classes. So sometimes you have the same classmates in first year until fourth year.
Oh, that's good. So you kind of create this close bond with your classmates.
And also like the extracurricular activities, it's a good way to engage and motivate yourself to go to school because you know so many people.
And it's good that you pointed that out because some international students have a hard time engaging with the setting. So it's good to be actively involved in organizations. But I appreciate you coming out here to share that. Anyway, guys, this is Paenn again. She's taking the therapeutic
recreation program.
Yeah. It's a degree program, and I'm just so happy that she's here.
Yay!
Thank you so much. Anyway, I digress, but in eighth place, if you're looking for a diploma program in practical nursing, well, there's an affordable one offered at Medicine Hat College, located at their campus in Brooks, Alberta. And interestingly enough, they offer clinical placement as part of your studies, which is great for those who like to travel and gain practical learning experiences in the field. The tuition cost per year is at $15,149. Coming in at seventh place is a familiar name, and that is the Southern Alberta Institute of Technology. And shout out to Melanie On Demand. She actually attended this school and is also a fellow YouTuber sharing her experiences on how she studied and eventually immigrated to Canada. Make sure to check out her video for helpful tips. Anyway, SAITE is located in Calgary, Alberta. They have a legal assistant diploma program with tuition cost at $14,611 per year. And you know what? This is somewhat similar to the school I attended here in BC, which was BCIT, because it seems like the school offers a lot of tech-related programs in automotive management, architectural technologies, and chemical laboratory technology. But do take note that these tech programs are higher in tuition cost at approximately $18,000 per year. I just thought of mentioning it for those looking into tech-related programs at Alberta. All right, so we are halfway through. Woohoo! Are you guys still with me? Okay, great, because in sixth place, we have Red Deer College. They offer a variety of diploma programs in network administration, software development, kinesiology, and sports studies, with tuition costs at $14,500 per year. Okay, change location. Okay. You guys dizzy? Dizzy like me? This is like my 10th try. Fifth place, we have Northwest College in Edmonton, Alberta. They have a two-year diploma program in environmental protection technology with tuition cost at $13,200 per year. Aside from that, they're also offering a diploma program in justice and disability studies with tuition cost at $13,410 per year. Fourth place, we have Bow Valley College, located in Calgary, Alberta as well. I actually visited the place last summer, but unfortunately I didn't get to see what's inside. Bow Valley College offers several programs in addiction studies, justice studies, and becoming a legal assistant. And the tuition cost is hovering at $12,400 per year. In third place, we have Lethbridge. Left? Or right? There's a two-year diploma program in interior design technology and multimedia production, as well as general arts and science in psychology and sociology. The tuition cost per year is at $12,150 per year. Now, in second place, we have Keano College, located in Fort McMurray, Alberta. The school has a diploma program in business administration and esports management. Oh, and some of their business administration programs offer a co-op option, which is worth considering if you're interested in working as part of your studies. The tuition cost per year is at $11,752 per year. Now, for first place, drumroll please. We have Medicine Hat College in Medicine Hat, Alberta. Now, I've actually mentioned this school already, but they actually have another campus offering affordable programs in business administration. The business administration program offers several concentrations in accounting, financial services, marketing, and management, with tuition costs at $10,673 per year. Next, here are a couple things worth noting about Alberta. First, let's go over some of the stats about the province. Alberta has currently a population of over 4 million people, and 54% of the population growth is due to immigration. The largest visible minorities in Alberta are South Asians, followed by Filipinos and Chinese. And for students planning to work part-time during their studies, the minimum wage in Alberta is one of the highest in Canada at $15 per hour. With all these factors, I understand why people are deciding to move here. It's affordable, naturesque, and there are a lot of friendly people. In fact, some of my closest friends are from Alberta. generally, Alberta has this laid-back pace, which was very calming and soothing for me. So I just want to share my experience when I visited the province a couple months ago. To be more specific, my partner and I went on a road trip to Banff, Calgary, and Edmonton. The drive to Calgary from Vancouver was approximately a 10-hour drive. Yeah, my partner and I loved it, especially our visit to the West Edmonton Mall. You know, it was just like a regular mall, riding on the back of a cheetah, drinking Red Bull while taking steroids. In short, this place was huge. It had a skating rink, an indoor amusement park, and a water park. It's crazy. But if you were to ask me my favorite part of the trip, it's when we got to explore the Bow River on a scooter. I don't know, if you want to explore any city quickly, you may consider checking it out on a scooter. And to cap off our trip, we even saw Justin Bieber. Well, Justin Bieber. But close enough. Now, in terms of the schools I've just mentioned, I'm gonna be honest. It's really hard for me to comment on a school without seeing it for myself, which is why I want to open the floor to current and even former international students that studied at Alberta. I'd really appreciate it if you could share your experiences by commenting down below. That way you can paint a better picture to my audience about what it's like to study, work, and eventually live in Alberta. But anyway, that's it. That's all I have for today. If you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, kindly like and subscribe. Let me know what province, school, or topic you'd like me to cover next by also commenting down below. Thank you again for watching. Be safe and be kind. And as always, I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.